This evening, we've all come together to do kirtan. Everyone here has heard of kirtan?
Well, you've heard it, that's for sure.
Kirtan is one of the processes of bhakti. Bhakti means love and devotion with a goal. Love and devotion to the Supreme Lord, God. We call God Krishna, the Supreme All-Attractive Person. In the Srimad Bhagavatam, the essence of all Vedic scriptures, there it is said, Shravanam, Kirtanam, Vishnu Smaranam, Pada Sevanam, Archanam, Bandhanam, Dasyam, Sakyam, Atma Nivedanam. Nine processes of devotion have been mentioned. And among those, the second one that is mentioned is Kirtan. Kirtan means the chanting of the holy names of the Lord. Especially with an intention. What is bhakti? When I say kirtan is a process of bhakti, then we must define bhakti. Bhakti means love and devotion for God, but it has a certain kind of nature. It means not asking for anything about the names of God. It is only for the happiness, the pleasure, the benefit of God. Does God need this?
No.
Does God like it? According to all of the scriptures, yes. Wherever the names of God, wherever the glories of God are being sung or chanted, you can read in almost any scripture of the world that believes in God. There it will mention wherever his name, wherever his glories are being sung. Where two or more persons are there, he is present in that place. There is a verse in the scriptures. The Supreme Lord is saying, I'm not present in Vaikuntha. Naham vasami Vaikunthe. Yoginam hridayenicha. I'm not even within the hearts of those persons who are trying to focus on me so that they can develop power. Where do I reside? Madbhakta yatra gayanti tatra tishthami narada. So the Lord is saying, O Narada, where do I reside? I reside in that place where my devotees are remembering me, where they are glorifying me, where they are chanting my names. Because he becomes attracted. Love and devotion to the Lord has this special power to attract him. Oh, where my devotees are, I am fully present in that place. We have an understanding that God is everywhere. But where there is connection, where there is love and affection, there is more depth of presence. So when we are doing kirtan, calling out the names of the Lord, it is a very powerful process. Actually, in the scriptures it is said that in this age is called Kali Yuga, the age of quarrel and hypocrisy. If you don't believe me, you can go online, check the internet, read any newspaper, see who the presidents of each country are and what they're doing. It's a very interesting time, the age of quarrel and hypocrisy. It is said that in this age it's very difficult to attain perfection through so many other processes. There is one amazing quality at this time, one amazing potency at this time, that simply by coming together and chanting the names of the Lord, all perfection can be attained. So it's a very, very powerful time and a very powerful process. Coming together in a group and opening our hearts, calling out the names of the Lord. Oh my Lord, I have been lost in this world. I don't know which way to go. I don't know how long, but I know that you are my eternal Lord. Please accept me. Please accept my heart. Please accept my love. When we're doing kirtan and calling out like that, it is very, very powerful. So, this is Krishna Kripa.
He's been traveling with us since he's 17 years old.